Hello. So today our topic of discussion is Cauda Equina syndrome. Now to begin with, we should know the normal anatomy, what constitute Cauda Equina and the other associated structure with the Cauda Equina. Now this is the distal part of spinal cord. Now as we know, the spinal cord ends at the level of L1, L2 vertebra, but the nerve roots from the L1 to S5, they will travel down to get exit from the corresponding vertebra. So this bunch of fibers, nerve roots, they will form the Cauda Equina. The name came from the shape of the horse tail, as it looked like a horse tail. Now another important structure here is the conus medullaris, which is the distal part of the Cauda Equina at the level of L1 and L2 vertebra. So conus medullaris is a part of the spinal cord. So it will include the distal sacral cord segments. So it will include the cord segments, motor part, but the Cauda Equina will include the nerve roots from L2 to the S5. So this will include the nerve roots, but conus medullaris will include the sacral cord segments, the anterior horn cells. So Cauda Equina syndrome is basically compression of this Cauda Equina part. So it will present as bilateral leg pain, or it will present as a back pain. So more predominantly it presents as a back pain. Another important finding is the saddle anesthesia. So saddle anesthesia, so this region is known as saddle anesthesia, this perianal part. So as there is involvement of the sacral nerve roots, so saddle anesthesia will be there. So central one is the S5, S4, S3 and S2. So this is known as the saddle anesthesia. So as there is compression of the nerve roots, there will be lower limb sensory and motor changing depending upon the what nerve roots are being compressed. And plus sacral segments, sacral nerve roots are involved. So there will be bladder bowel dysfunction. So this four feature will be seen in Cauda Equina syndrome. So there will be back pain or bilateral leg pain, there will be saddle anesthesia, there will be lower limb sensory motor changes, and there will be bladder and bowel dysfunction. Now what are all the causes of the Cauda Equina? So any compression to the Cauda Equina part is known as Cauda Equina syndrome. Now compression can be due to any space occupying lesion. Most commonly it is a disc herniation. Now it needs to be a central disc herniation to compress the Cauda Equina part, because paracentral one, which is the more common one, will compress the individual nerve root, but the central compression will compress the Cauda Equina. So this is the normal, this is the dural sac including the fibers. So here is the most common disc herniation, which is the paracentral, which will cause the individual nerve root compression. But in Cauda Equina there is a central compression to the dural sac, which will constitute the Cauda Equina syndrome. So this central compression is the most common cause of the Cauda Equina. So this is the first cause, is central disc herniation. Other causes can be spinal stenosis because of the thickening of the ligamentum flavum, or facet arthropathy, so they can cause the spinal stenosis. Other rare causes are tumors, trauma, any retropulsion of the fragment compressing the spinal cord, or any epidural hematoma or abscess. So any space occupying lesion which will cause the compression, central compression of the thecal sac, will constitute the Cauda Equina syndrome in the Cauda Equina region. So physical examination. So on inspection, if the patient is presenting late, there might be atrophy, as there is a lower limb sensory motor weakness. So motor weakness might lead to the atrophy of the muscles. Plus on palpation, there might be a tenderness over the region of the involved area. More important one are the motor, sensory and the reflexes. So depending upon the what or nerve fiber have been involved, there will be motor, sensory and the reflex changes in that particular nerve roots. Another important part is the rectal examination. So as we have discussed, there will be reduced or absence of the paranesthesia, plus the rectal tone will be decreased, and the anal wink and the bulbocavernous reflex will be either impaired or it will be absent. So coming to the imaging modalities, X-rays don't constitute an important, but they are always the primary thing that need to be done in any investigation. But much important is the emergency MRI. So Cauda Equina is one of the rare emergency situations in orthopedics, which might be non-traumatic. So MRI and the CT myelography in those cases where MRI cannot be done. So MRI, emergency MRI needs to be done and to look for the any space occupying lesion. So this MRI sagittal and axial view shows. So this sagittal and the axial view shows the disc herniation. So we can see extrusion type of the disc herniation, and on axial view we can see it is the central type of the disc herniation compressing the dural sac. So this is the most common cause of the Cauda Equina syndrome. So once the diagnosis has been made and it has been confirmed on the imaging by MRI, so we should go for the early decompression. So decompression will be in the form of discectomy, plus if any of the spinal stenosis or other things are present, so the lesion needs to be removed. So as the most common is the disc herniation, so discectomy is the most common procedure done with or without laminectomy. So it needs to be done in within the 48 hours to get improved the various bladder bowel symptoms. So this is one of the rare emergency situations in orthopedics. So Cauda Equina syndrome needs to be differentiated from the conus medullaris syndrome. So as we have already discussed, the conus medullaris is the distal part of the spinal cord, which include the sacral cord segments. So this is the distal part of the spinal cord, including the sacral cord segment situated in the L1, L2 region, while the Cauda Equina forms the nerve roots from L2 to the sacrum. So any compression at this level will cause the Cauda Equina conus medullary syndrome, and any compression at the Cauda Equina will cause the Cauda Equina syndrome. Now to differentiate between the two, so first is the level. So Cauda Equina level is L2 to sacrum. So any compression at the region of the L2 to sacrum will cause Cauda Equina, while L1 and L2 will cause the conus medullaris. So it will involve the lumbosacral roots, while this region will involve the sacral cord segments, So it is more, as it is involving the roots, it is more likely to be an asymmetrical one, while conus medullaris is a symmetrical as it is involving the cord itself. So as the roots are involved, the lower extremity involvement is much more, while as the sacral cords segments involved, the bladder bowel and the sexual impairment is more likely in conus medullaris. So as lower limb extremity is more there, there will be decreased muscle strength in Cauda Equina, while it will be a mild in conus medullaris, as lower extremity is less involved in conus medullaris. As it is involving only the roots part, so it is more a lower motor type of lesion, while it is involving the cord, it is more of a upper motor, but still it is a transition area, so mixed feature of the upper motor neuron and the lower motor neuron can be seen. So features of the lower motor lesion, tendon reflexes will be hyperreflexia, while here it can be mixed type or it can be a hyperreflexia. There won't be a Babinski reflex, there will be a Babinski reflex. There won't be a bulbocavernous reflex, there will be a bulbocavernous reflex. And plus the bowel bladder involvement is late and it is mild, while in conus medullaris, as the sacral cord segments are involved itself, the bowel bladder involvement will be early and more severe. So briefly summarizing, so spinal cord, conus medullaris and cauda equina. So differentiating between the cauda equina and conus medullaris is very important. So these are the some other features. Level we have discussed, spinal level, vertebral level we have discussed. Presentation, conus medullaris will be symmetrical, it will be bilateral and sudden, whereas cauda equina will be more gradual and unilateral. Radicular pain won't be here in conus medullaris, while it will be more severe in cauda equina as it is involving the nerve roots. Low back pain will be more in conus medullaris, while in cauda equina it will be less. Motor strength, it is symmetrical and it is less marked with hyperreflexia, while here it is more marked and it is asymmetrical with areflexia. Reflexes, ankle jerks can be affected, both can be affected. Sensory, it is localized numbness only in the region of the perianal. It is symmetrical and bilateral, while here it is localized numbness at the saddle area and it is asymmetrical or unilateral. Sphincter dysfunction is early, sphincter dysfunction is late, and impotency is more frequent in conus medullaris and impotency is less frequent in case of the cauda equina. So that was all about the cauda equina syndrome. So important part is the emergency diagnosis of cauda equina, the various features of the cauda equina, the need for the early decompression in the cauda equina, plus the various findings on the rectal examination and the motor sensory examination. Complication there, as if the decompression is done late, there is less chances of the recovery of the bowel and bladder. So that was all about the cauda equina syndrome. Kindly comment down below any suggestion and queries.